Getting off the stuff that you've done while you were out here and by yourself on your own.
But, yes.
And being in the group with a lot of support from the group, that helps.
Yes.
How long has it been since you've had a drink?
I had to get drunk last night to go to sleep. I relapsed a few weeks ago, and I'm still struggling with that, and it's harder than, you know, than it looks. I'm not doing as well as I'm letting on.
I've heard from countless homeless people that they drink so that they can sleep.
Yeah.
Does it just put you in a stupor? Does it block out noise? How does drinking alcohol, getting dead drunk, help?
Well, with me, it makes it so I can't dream. You know, I've done a lot of messed up stuff in my life, and I relive all that in my dreams. Like my car accident, I see, like around when it happens, I see it not from my point of view, but from a third party point of view. I actually watch the car accident.
You do not want to dream about this.
No, I don't.
Have you said everything to folks that you want to say, that you feel they should know?
Yes, I'm sick of the prejudice against me, and people need to know me for who I am, not what I did.
I know from people who talked about you to me, and just from our short contact, that you are a highly intelligent person, that you are oriented in time and space,
yeah,
which means you know where you are right now,
yeah,
and what time it is,
mm-hmm,
and that you're goal oriented. Mike told me you did some research for him in this library that we're sitting next to here.
Yeah.
He told me you have a lot of facts and figures at your command. I also really like your honesty and your willingness to talk honestly about the way you see things.
Yeah, that was one of the issues that my people had with me back in Pennsylvania, because I'm open about all my problems. I always tell people, you know, if you want to know something, just ask. Take the time, sit down and talk to me.
What was the key thing you wanted people to know about you?
That I'm not some junky psychopath, that, you know, I'm intelligent and I just like to get stuff done. My methodology ain't always the best thing, because, you know, I'm kind of sick. And I try not to act on what goes through my head, because it's very, very hard at times.
You have had an intention to try to get off a series of drugs, a series of substances.
Yes.
And you've worked at it.
Yeah.
It's been an important thing. You've taken major steps to do it.
Yes.
Yeah.
One of the major issues I deal with is my schizophrenia. I know it's nothing more than a chemical imbalance. Brain chemicals out of whack, that's all it is.
You are aware enough of your disease to know that you have chemical imbalance in your brain.
Yes.
It's not like you're so caught in this that you're unaware of this. You
yes.
know about it.
Yes.
Okay.
And part of my disease is I'll sit there and I'll look at people, like most, like people walking down the street, I'll see zombies, I'll see dead bodies, I'll see corpses. Some of them will look fresh, some of them look like something out of like Land of the Dead and Night of the Living Dead.
And these are hallucinations.
Yes, they're full visual hallucinations. I'll sit there and interact with them, because I know that 9 times out of 10 they are actually there, but their appearance is in my head. I don't know what causes it.
And you know that they're not really there.
Yes, the features, it's something that to describe it is one thing, but to actually go through it is something else, and it scares me. But I also know that they're human, they're people, and even though I joke about zombies and a zombie apocalypse all the time, but I don't like hurting anybody. I never want to hurt anybody, you know, because human life is precious.
So even though you might have an impulse to hurt these zombies or make these zombies or hallucinations go away, why don't you?
Because I know it's in my head. It's just a chemical imbalance.
And you know this at all times?
Yes.
Unless you've been drinking heavily and you're in a blackout.
Yeah, I just sit there and try to destroy them. Because, you know, stuff like that, when I'm in an altered state, they appear to be like, the easiest way to describe it is an abomination. It's something that's not natural, something that's not normal, and it just happens.
So you have coping mechanisms to make yourself not hurt them?
Yes.
How does that work?
Actually, it works really good, because it keeps me out of jail and nobody likes being locked in a cage.
So you stop yourself?
Yes, I stop myself before I do something stupid. I've actually had to stop myself a few times when I had weapons in my hands. I had to ask myself, what's wrong with me? What are you doing?
And have you been successful with that?
Yes, there was an incident in Berkeley involving a sleeping bag, and I caught myself mid-swing with a skateboard. I had to go for a walk and went for a walk for a few hours.
So you just cooled off?
Yes.
You took a time out?
Yeah.
And the other time this happened was when you were on the roof.
Yes.
At 888 Turk, and you were in a blackout. Being in the blackout made you unable to stop lobbing the bricks. And
yes.
Also, do I understand, too, you were in military stance. You were just following orders.
Yeah.
You saw a military enemy, and you were doing what you were told to do in the military.
Yeah, they trained me in self-preservation, and they were pointing weapons at me. So specifically, the one SWAT officer that shot the beanbag round at me. That was the SUV I was accused of smashing up. I was just trying to get him to put his head down so I could back away and not get shot.
So you lobbed the thing instead of targeting
anybody. I was actually aiming them, those pipes I threw at him, because from the location of the blows on the damage on the SUV, it looked like a direct line of fire from the roof to the vehicle.
But you only know this because you were told about it after the fact. Is that right?
I've read the police reports.
Okay. You weren't aware of it during the time you were throwing the pipes?
No, I was not aware of it.
What you're describing is something that you were told or shown after the incident.
Yes. When I was on that second roof, it was automatic straight combat training, and I slipped back into instincts.
You kicked into that automatic reaction.
Yes.
Yeah. The way you were trained in the military.
Yes.
You are a person with schizophrenia,
mm-hmm.
who has visions and hallucinations that that seduce you or prompt you to act out on people, but
yes.
You know those hallucinations aren't real.
Yes.
And you stop yourself.
Most of the time I do. When I'm inebriated, it's very, very hard because I got very bad impulse control.
So how do you handle that? Do you try to not get inebriated as much as possible?
I smoke a lot of marijuana. That actually works.
Does marijuana help you sleep?
It helps me sleep, helps me eat. It just keeps me calm and mellow. It keeps me from putting other chemicals in me. My chemical imbalances, you know, they have a root cause. My mother spent 5 years in a Kansas State psychiatric hospital for schizophrenia. She's been in hospitals multiple times. Throughout my life, I could be honest about this. Me and my oldest sister helped raise my younger three siblings because my dad had to work and my mom would be in the psych ward. And it was hard for everybody. And her DNA, her genetics passed into me. I'm the only one out of all of us that has these problems.
That really is an important empirical fact that you're the only one and that your other siblings don't have this effect.
Yeah.
Now, you also told me a minute ago that you've been on various drugs for schizophrenia.
Yes.
And so talk about what you've been on and what the effect on you is and why you're not on those drugs now.
Since I was 16, I've been on various cocktails of medications. I've taken Tegretol, Risperidol, Abilify, which is basically like zombie medication. I was supposed to be painting a living room. All I was able to do was sit there and sit on the couch and drool while I watched cartoons.
You couldn't complete a task while you were on this stuff.
Yeah, and plus I was on from how long I had to be taking the medications. I can't remember all of them. I remember I was on Effexor when I came back from South Korea, and it's not good for you. That stuff, it eats your liver away, your internal organs. That's why I smoke all the pot I smoke.
You will not take these things because you know the side effects on you. And you find that pot really works well.
Yeah, it's the best thing you can take.
Yeah. I understand you can also get marijuana in various forms that don't involve getting high if you want to use it for medical purposes.
Yeah, there's the, I think it's called Marinol, which you can get it at pharmacies if you can get the prescription for it. And of course, there's always the edibles and various forms of THC, but it all does the same thing. Different forms do have different effects.
Thanks for that information.
Love them.